Change has come to the Garlean Empire, and we must discuss the implications.
The rumors are true, then? The War of Succession is ended?
It is. A new emperor reigns in Garlemald.
Who?
The birth and all too rapid expansion of the Garlean Empire is commonly attributed to the strategic brilliance of Solus Zosgalvis, yet he did not rule alone. Several members of the royal household also distinguished themselves during his reign. Nevertheless, it was the eldest son who stood to inherit the throne, until his most untimely passing.
I thought us fortunate when I learned that the Emperor had died without naming a successor.
Would that the Garlean Empire had died with him.
Was the grandson and his uncle who had the strongest claims, was it not?
Indeed. Yet claims count for little without the power to assert them. High Legatus Varus Ye Galvis is a respected military leader, not so his uncle.
So young Varus has torn the crown from his uncle's grasp and taken his place at the head of the Empire.
Given the troubled nature of his succession, the new Emperor will require time to seal his grip on power. Yet have no doubt but that he shall, for there are none left with strength enough to oppose him.
Since the success of Operation Archon, the remnants of the 14th Legion and the forces occupying Alamigo have done naught but fortify their positions. But you can be sure they'll be ready to march on us again, if their Emperor gives the word.
When? Not if. They say this Varus was so set upon Eorzean annexation that he spoke out against the Meteor Project.
Plainly, the new Emperor's intentions are of great concern to us all. I propose that we set aside the Cardano dispute for the present and discuss what measures the Alliance might take to prepare for a resumption of hostilities with Garlemald. Moreover, I move that we re-examine the question of how our former allies in Ishgard might be persuaded to retake their place at our side. Could Eorzea but stand as one, 'twould deal a grave blow to our enemies' ambitions.
Well, I suppose we should be grateful that they have finally acknowledged the inevitability of Imperial attack. Who knows? They may even do something about it. If only the leaders of Ishgard would follow their example and stop hiding behind their gates, praying for the coming storm to pass them by. But that is a discussion for another time. At present, I am more concerned by the fact that the Alliance's mooted preparations will be made known to the Garlians many moons before their coming. So long as the Ivy eludes our grasp, no secret is safe.
Thank you. Minfilia, am I right?
None other. I bid you welcome to Revenant's Toll, and thank you for traveling so far on such short notice.
As if I could ever say no to Urianje.
Moonbreeder is an accomplished Charlian scholar, and an authority on aetherite technologies. She has played an invaluable role in our search for a means to capture Arcean souls.
Charmed, I'm sure.
It's been ages!
Oh, longer, sister!
A joyous reunion indeed.
Well, of course it is! Moon and I are like twin sisters.
Save in appearance and aptitude.
Everyone, if I could have your attention. We have with us an esteemed guest who has come from Charlian to assist us. I bid Moonbreeder join us here that she might share with us her extensive knowledge of aetherites. Also, as many of you are already aware, she has been overseeing our research into white aurasite, a sample of which she has been good enough to bring with her.
Well, I had to come, didn't I? You'd have to be bloody daft to turn your nose up at a chance like this. Where better to conduct my final tests than a land so steeped in ether you can taste it?
'Tis plain the passage of the years hath done little to dampen thy youthful spirits. And nothing at all to reform thy youthful manner.
Where in the hells have you been hiding?
Unhand me.
I come all this way, and that's what you have to say to me. I much preferred when you were pleading with me to drop everything and hurry to your side. What was it you said? None save thee can satisfy this need.
Go on.
Thine artless attempts to misrepresent mine all too innocent motives do thee little credit. Mine intent, as well thou knowest, was but to impress upon thee the gravity of the circumstance. Lest thou doubt, a deiform entity shall shortly be summoned. Save if thou, and no other, grantest my compeers thine aid.
You still haven't found it, then, your missing aetherite?
We have not, no. We know that Iceheart teleported to an aetherite not far from the first, Yet even after careful analysis, we could not locate a second beacon. We now suspect that the heretics destroyed the second aetherite to impede our pursuit. Our allies continue to scour Snowcloak for Ice Hut Sanctuary, but we have no guarantee that they will find it. Yet it must be found, for even now Ice Hut prepares to call upon Saint Shiva.
I'm sorry, but if the aetherite's been destroyed, then that's that. Although, you're absolutely sure she used the first aetherite, are you? She didn't just use teleportation magics.
One of our own bore witness to her escape. I can say with absolute certainty that Iceheart used the aetherite.
In that case, there might be a way, so long as the ethereal current is still flowing.
Truly? How?
We use the current to recreate the beacon. As you know, aetherites are a bit like lighthouses. We use them to reconstitute our physical forms when crossing the ethereal sea. Without them, we'd lose all sense of direction and our essence would dissipate. However, we don't rely solely on these beacons. There are currents of ether which flow between them, currents which help guide us to our destination. Now, these currents will gradually dwindle away to nothing if an aetherite is destroyed. But if even a sluggish flow remains, we could theoretically use it to direct a surge of concentrated ether towards the void left by the beacon, and thereby fill it up again.
Like opening the floodgates to fill a dry riverbed. Though, correct me if I'm wrong, but would we not need a veritable reservoir of ether?
In concert, we might manage to channel a sufficient volume, yet that is not my chief concern. To direct the flow of so great a volume of ether with the requisite precision would be a nigh impossible task in itself.
I barely succeeded in facilitating travel to an unattuned beacon. That which you describe sounds considerably more difficult.
And dangerous. Every person who has attempted to teleport in this fashion has died in the process. They, however, did not have white aura sight at their disposal. I can use it to channel all the ether you can give me into the aetherite. However, white aura sight cannot retain ether for an extended period of time, so we would need to infuse it immediately beforehand. Just so you know, I'd confidently give this plan better than even odds of success. And if the worst comes to worst, your people won't suffer.
Though it risk the lives of our best and brightest, we have not the time to seek other options. If the ethereal current still flows, we shall carry out Moonbreeder's plan.
That's the spirit. Let's roll the dice.